Taylor Swift wrote a trilogy? That's right, we got Taylor Tolkien on deck today. You guys have been begging me to dive into this one from the folklore days. Apparently, there were three songs that are supposed to go together with each other. So that's exactly what we're going to do today. We're going to line them up and go back to back to back and check out Taylor's storytelling. So this right here right now is none other than Cardigan, August, and Betty. That piano needs to clean it.
Vintage tea. Brand new phone, high heels on, cobblestones, when you...
I love the opening of that juxtaposition. Vintage tea, old school, but with a brand new phone. Sounds like a stylistic choice. And where are we? Away in the woods in a cabin right now? Let's get it, Taylor. Oh, that didn't work.
High heels on, cobblestones, when you are young, they assume you know nothing.
It's so true. The innocence and ignorance of youth. People think that with age means wisdom comes automatically. I'm gonna let you guys in on a secret. It doesn't.
Cobblestones, when you are young, they assume you know nothing. Sequin smile, black lipstick, sensual politics. When you are young, they assume you know nothing.
Sequin smile. I like the way that that's put, because to me, that's something like glitzy and sort of sequin in a fashion. So it's like, it's very shallow on the surface. It's meant to shine. It's meant to maybe kind of distract. And that's kind of playing off of this innocence of youth. And I love this sort of like drop down whispered tone, almost like she's reflecting and she's taking us back. And it's got that nostalgic feel to it. And I love the contradiction of kind of the smooth melodies of the piano, like out over top of the mix. But then underneath, you just have that sort of percussion kind of running in a different direction. And it feels very like raw, kind of like in a studio session, just in that moment. See where we go with this. What's happening?
When you are young, they assume you know nothing.
Oh. But oh, that's normal. It's a magic piano.
I knew you dancing in your Levi's, drunk under a street light. I knew you hand under my sweatshirt, baby, kiss it better.
Hand under her sweatshirt. Where's that hand going? We're not playing baseball here.
Sweatshirt, baby, kiss it better. And when I felt like I was an old cardigan under someone's bed, you put me on and said I was your favorite.
When I felt like I was an old cardigan under someone's bed, which is interesting to put it in that way, because she's talking about sort of the blissfulness and ignorance of youth and young love, I get the vibe from. So then to relate it to an old cardigan, as time passed, or still she's just using that as like a metaphor for her self-worth and how she felt. And yet you still picked it up and you still put it on. And like putting someone on, like giving them a chance, putting on for them, or it could be putting on like you're misleading. There could be something sinister underneath, but I don't know where we're going yet. Let's see, we're in like this new magical world of Avatar. All of a sudden she's been transported to in the piano.
That was your favorite.
So the plot thickens, right? A friend to all, a friend to none. That's a great quote. That is that's Greek philosophers. Is that Aristotle we're going back to? I think so. Chasing two girls. Not getting any of them, really. So, Mr. The understood you that she's singing to in this sounds like a little player.
When you are young, they assume you know not-
I love the water just cascading from the piano there. Piano waterfall, that's a first.
Seeking, me a weekend's eye.
Hang on, what was that like?
Seeking, me a weekend's eye.
Hide and seek, giving me your weekends. That's interesting, because if there's two girls involved, he could be playing hide and seek like he's ghosting her sometimes because he's with the other girl, right? And then also you play off of this sort of, you know, youthful innocence taking us back to the days of like when we used to play hide and seek as kids.
Hide and seek.
she's always really clever in just sort of like capturing the world and the theme and sort of the word choice that she uses for whatever picture she's trying to paint and how she's trying to like give us this message. Like the word choice is so key and important. So that's why I'm highlighting like a simple line like hide and seek ties in with sort of this youthful bliss and this reflection of going back that we're thinking of here with the song. Giving me a weekend's eye. I knew you, your heartbeat on the high line, once in 20 lifetimes. Heartbeat on the high line, NYC high line. And when I felt like I was an old cardigan under someone's bed, you put me on and said I was your favorite. You drew stars around my scars, but now I'm bleeding. Really like the poetic nature of that line. Oh, okay. So we've left this like blissful landscape and now she's like trying to stay afloat, almost like the relationship taking a turn now and she's treading the waters. Like a bloodstain, I knew you tried to change the ending. Peter losing Wendy, I knew you. Peter Pan bars? What in the Disney's happening? Try to change the ending, Peter losing Wendy. Yeah, because, you know, the theme of Peter Pan is sort of that youthful love, kind of like what she's described. Oh, that's clever. You know how I said that she's really good at her sort of metaphors and word choice, like staying in that world? So for me, like something youthful, like the childhood stories of Peter Pan. So she's tying back with that reflective feel versus this like very youthful, ignorant love, almost that like Peter has for Wendy. But Wendy chooses to go back to the real world and to grow up one day. And she realizes that, you know, that love of youth and childhood is different than like a lasting love in a relationship that you grow old with someone. One is playful, one is a lot more sort of serious. So relating and tying in that world. And oh, when she passes through the gold, she's like, yeah, she's in like Neverland here. Nice. I knew you tried to change the ending. Peter losing Wendy. I knew you leaving like a father, running like water. Leaving like a father. Oh, that hits heavy. I guess dad's not paying child support. Obviously, it relates to the character because I don't know enough about her personal story, but was her dad there for her? I don't know that. I think it's more in character of what she's writing. When you are young, they assume you know nothing. And obviously, a father is someone that you love and hold dear. So to be left, you're crushed, just like whoever he is that she's writing about, leaving her crush and one that she can. I knew everything when I was young. Now it's the I knew everything. When before, they say you know nothing when you're young. Notice how she's flipped that sentiment now. Chasing shadows in the grocery line. I knew you'd miss me once the thrill expired. And you'd be standing in my front porch light. And I knew you'd come back to me. Once the thrill expired. And she talked about playing off of what ifs. I just love simple sort of one-liners that we all can relate to in relationships. And how many of us go back and play the sort of what if game. But for him, the thrill expired, right? And we talked about two. So I'm thinking that chase of being with someone else expired. And now he's coming back, crawling to her, begging for her to take him back. You come back to me.
I was was your favorite?
That's almost like, it's either like very like bouncy sing, like just the way that that's hitting sounds like synths that are strings that have just been almost sort of reversed, and they've got sort of that like callous hit to the mix, right? They're almost like clashing because they're playing sort of anti-harmoniously versus the harmony of the piano. I think that this is important right here from a production perspective because it represents like a tonal change as we come out of this. Sounds like a percussive line being played in reverse too, like way down in the mix. Yeah, really interesting mixing on this because like that smooth piano sat over top and she could have scaled it back and just focused on that. But instead there was really a lot happening sort of atmospherically. Like I heard like different string instrumentation, different things happening with the percussion in the mix, some synths kind of like bouncing around in the atmosphere. So you had this like juxtaposition of what was out in front with that piano versus everything happening behind it, but it never kind of took over. It was always like sort of subdued and back there and just adding a different sort of element and composition to it all. Oh, interesting. So she filmed that back in 2020, right? All right, well, that was Cardigan. Let's see what's next. One.
Salt air and the rust on your door. I never needed anything more.
Salt air because the salt can lead to a lot of corrosion and rust. So that's changed because we had the Highline lines making me think of like the city. And the cobblestone streets, so now like a beach sort of environment and atmosphere.
I never needed.
You can like just see the outline of maybe water in the background of this picture.
Anything more or whispers of are you sure? Never have I ever before. But I can see us lost in the memory of.
Are you sure? Sounds like teenagers giving away that V card.
Before, but I
or playing Never Have I Ever.
In the memory, August slipped away into a moment in time. Cause it was never mine. And I can see us twisted in bedsheets. August slipped away like a bottle of wine. Cause you were never mine. You're back beneath the sun.
Cause you were never mine. And see, it kind of twists because you could think, are they talking about the month of August? Because this was like a summer fling. So sort of the transient nature of that, or that person was never theirs. I wonder from whose perspective she's writing right now.
Back beneath the sun, wishing I could write my name on it. Will you call when you're back at school?
Yeah, definitely a summer fling now. Will you call when you're back at school?
I can see us lost in the memory. August slipped away into a moment in time. Cause it was never mine. And I can see us twisted in bedsheets. August sipped away like a bottle of wine.
I can see us August. Like just the way that she sort of slant rhymed August with I can't. Because of the way that it's sang and that tone and cadence. It's just clever writing right there.
Twisted in bed sheets, August sipped away like a bottle of wine. Cause you were never mine.
Just in case you call and say, meet me behind the mall. So much for summer love and saying, so much for Summer Love and saying us because you weren't mine to lose. Sounds like she's more invested than he is. If that's the case, or is it the he to she? I'm still not sure whose perspective this is. But see, the first track we had the illusion of a love triangle going on, which is starting to make me suspect and connect the trilogy to a triangle here, right? And maybe we're getting three different perspectives. And this sounds like more of a her perspective in terms of the other girl, maybe, in the summer fling and love, because if he's with the girl who was singing about Cardigan, right? Then that's why you were never mine to lose, because he's with someone else. Da 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 to a moment in time. I love just kind of like, we're kind of like dancing, sort of staccato delivery up here, and then she like brings you down and mellows you through it. 'Cause it was never mine, and I can see us twisted in bed sheets. I get sipped away like a bottle of wine. 'Cause you were never mine. 'Cause you were never mine. Do you remember? Remember when I pulled up and said, get in the car, and then canceled my plans just in case you call? Back when I was living for the hope of it all, for the hope of it all, meet me behind the mall. Remember when I love how that's like so distant and far away. To me, that reflects kind of looking back on the past and it really being a memory. Hold up and say, get in the car, and then get to my plans just in case you call. Back when I was living for the hope of it all. For the hope of it all. For the hope of it all. I wonder if Travis Kelce has this depth, right? What is she seeing him? I mean, yeah, he's a professional athlete. He's a baller. But maybe he's just like a secret poet. I don't know why I went off on that tangent. I definitely think that the plot is thickening. Let's do Betty now. One.
Betty, I won't make assumptions about why you switched your homeroom, but
harmonica is such a beautiful, sad instrument. Betty, I won't make assumptions. Hang
Betty,
on.
I won't make assumptions about why you switched your homeroom, but I think it's 'cause of me. Betty, one time I was riding on my skateboard when I passed your house. It's like I couldn't breathe. You heard the rumors from Inez. You can't believe a word she says most times, but this time it was true. The worst thing that I ever did was what I did to you.
Ah! So we have the one causing all of this love triangle here. This is definitely now his perspective speaking to Betty. And switching homerooms makes me think of being back at school, which takes me back to the first track, to Cardigan. This is not talking to the love interest that's involved in August, because August was a summer fling and more of a transient thing. This is back Notice the fall leaves on the ground and reflecting like going back to school. Ooh, okay.
I did to you. But if I just showed up at your party, would you have me? Would you want me? Would you tell me to go fuck myself? Or lead me to the garden? In the garden, would you trust me if I told you it was just a summer thing? Mm. I'm only 17, I don't know anything, but I know I miss you.
I'm only 17, you know what? I talked about all those references to like young, innocent, teenage type of love. Well, there we go. It all comes around full circle, and it being a summer fling and this love triangle and what he did cheating on her with this other girl.
17, I don't know any.
Which is funny though, because she's told about that summer fling not from his perspective but from the other girl's perspective, who obviously was more invested than he was. To him, it was a, you know, a distraction, a side road from the main road that he was on, but for her it meant a lot more. Love the way that she's really like dove into the world of all three of these characters and told it, you know, from their perspective. Very clever storytelling writing here.
But I know I miss you. Betty, I know where it all went wrong. Your favorite song was playing from the far side of the gym. I was nowhere to be found. I hate the crowds, you know that. Plus, I saw you dance with him. You heard the.
Oh, typical cheater here playing victim mentality. I saw you dancing with him, even though it was my fault because I didn't like crowds and I wasn't dancing with you. So that's the reason why I cheated. It's really your fault. If you didn't do that situation, I wouldn't have done what I had done.
I saw you dance with him. You heard the. Can't believe a word she says most times, but this time it was true. The worst thing that I ever did was what I did to you. But if I just showed up at your party, would you have me? Would you want me? Would you tell me to go fuck myself? Or lead me to the garden? In the garden, would you trust me if I told you it was just a summer thing? I'm only 17, I don't know anything, but I know I miss you.
Remember the cobblestones from Cardigan? Her high heels on the cobblestones? How it comes back around.
On broken cobblestones, just thinking of you when she pulled up like a big man of my worst intentions. She said, James, get in, let's drive. Those days turned into nights.
Da, 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 da. That, that very dope sort of flow, almost like a rapper's flow, like turning it into a percussive like just beat right there.
James, get in.
And we've got a name, James.
Let's drive. Those days turned into nights. Slept next to her, but I dreamt of you all summer long.
I don't know if there's comfort to be taken in that. Well, I was sleeping with her and, you know, things were happening. Don't worry, it's okay. I was thinking about you.
Doorstep, and I planned it out for weeks now, but it's finally sinking in. Betty, right now is the last time I can dream about what happens when you see my face again. The only thing I wanna do is make it up to you. So I showed up at your party. Yeah, I showed up at your party.
But what? Does she take him back? I don't know. The suspense is building.
Yeah, I
Again, this whole not knowing anything for being young that she talked about in the first song in Cardigan. Notice how there's a lot of sort of parallels and connections to the lyricism that she ties and brings back around later on.
Standing in your cardigan.
And now back to the cardigan. Clever. Wow. I'm kind of sad. You know what? I think what's really interesting is that Peter Pan theme and how I talked about childlike love like Peter had for Wendy and wanting to stay as a child and stay young and stay wrapped in that youthful innocence and bliss for forever and romanticizing that versus, you know, maturing and coming along in age and then looking for something more concrete with love. And I think there's a little bit of that sort of childhood fantasy and innocence here. That sort of, I'm only 17. That's not childhood, I know, but I'm talking about just, you know, young love, youthful love that can be more ignorant. But at the time, it feels like it's the biggest, most important moment of our lives and we're never going to recover. Sorry, Cameron died at the worst time, but you know, we're never going to recover and get over from that. And she plays off of that theme very cleverly through the writing. And then I also just really appreciate the storytelling. The fact that she took a love triangle and wrote one song representing each person's perspective. And then again, like we talked about, the cardigan themes, the cobblestone streets, knowing nothing, a lot of her lyricism that ties it all back together and brings it all around. And what's really, really interesting to me is that this is a very mature sounding song from Taylor. It just represents a sort of different level of writing from her versus the topics that are being explored. But yeah, storytelling classic. Taylor Swift, you are not so certified. Hope you guys liked today's video. Listen, I know it was a little bit of a longer one, so do me a huge favor. If you're here at the end still, subscribe, notifications on, support the channel directly. It really, really does go a long way. I love you guys. Hey, safe, stay positive. It's Wally Knoxhill. You know, I'll catch you again.